I went to the State University of Buffalo, New York, did my bachelor's degree in electrical and computer engineering. So my actual final year research project was to access neural network from a K9Q platform. And when I was about to finish my master's, I had an interesting encounter with an individual called Dr. Prabhat Samaratunga. They were about to start the first internet company in Sri Lanka. This was somewhere around 1994. Both of them together, they actually decided to hire me as the second employee of Lanka Internet. And then one of the first projects, even before I started working for the company, was to build a website for the company primarily, but actually that happened to be the first commercial website in Sri Lanka. This would have been somewhere around 1994, September, October time frame, where I built the first commercial website in Sri Lanka, which was www.lanka.net. The site still remains, but the ownership may have changed, but the site still remains. So www.lanka.net was the first commercial website, which was actually built in the back of a house of another academic who was also a director of Lanka Internet, who was Professor Saman Amarasinghe. Then subsequently, I came back to Sri Lanka in January of 1995 and basically helped to set up the first commercial internet company in Sri Lanka, which was Lanka Internet. Then subsequently setting up the first email server, which was sri.lanka.net. You know, we started the first newspaper online, which was Daily News and Sunday Observer. We also did the first radio station online, which is real-time broadcasting using Real Audio, which was TNL Radio. Subsequently, we also established the first Wi-Fi network in Sri Lanka, which was using spread spectrum technology. Then I wanted to experiment with something, which was a revolution at that time, which was the open source movement. And actually, I wanted to start a company basically to provide services using open source technology. So my proposition was to take open source technology and build user interfaces which were very user friendly. So I turned 360 degrees, I joined Microsoft, which was at the end of the spectrum. But I think one of the interesting things that I got involved while I was at Microsoft, I started looking at different opportunities and then saw that the ICT agency was involved in the systems to be local language enabled. An interesting project got involved was a language pack developed for Sinhala and Tamil for Microsoft Office and Windows. Then subsequently, I moved to IBM from Microsoft, and I was responsible for heading the software business for IBM. From there onwards, with my technology background of 20 plus years, I got the greatest opportunity in my career of joining Lanka Clear. The company is actually owned by Central Bank and all the commercial banks in Sri Lanka. And Lanka Clear started in 2002 for the sole purpose of automating the check clearance process in Sri Lanka. There were so many other services that required automation. So one such service was actually payments, to especially salary payments and bulk payments as such, EPF, ETF and so many other bulk payments, which were taking so many days to go from one bank to the other. The process that was started was called Sri Lanka Interbank Payment System, or SLIPS in short. So what Lanka Clear did was primarily make this a T+0 affair, which means it's not a real-time payment, but if you make the request in the morning, by afternoon you get the payment. As a progressive step, what also the country and central bank primarily realized was now the banks have getting more and more digital, and they have started deploying all the ATMs around the country. But if you really look at the entire country, a single bank cannot cover the entire country because the cost would be prohibitive if they have to establish ATMs all over the place. What central bank initially wanted was at least to get the three state banks. So Lanka Clear's task was to initially link these three banks' ATMs together using a common ATM switch, which later on was extended to all the banks. So now almost 98% of the country's ATMs, which is 3,600 plus, is linked through Lanka Clear. So then we went ahead by launching the real-time or electronic fund transfer switch, where a customer of a bank can transfer money to customer of any other bank real time. But our next step is primarily starting the smartphone-based payment revolution. Our primary objective of setting up Lanka Clear is to ensure financial inclusivity. Take the technology-based payments to the rural and do it at a nominal cost and in a secure way. So hopefully we are on our way to do that.